If he just let me get in the ring, we fought fair, it might have been a different story. What's up, guys? WWE superstar Seth freaking Rollins here, and we are watching back my WrestleMania 35 match with the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar. And this is presented by Wendy's. Not all hamburgers are created equal. Choose the square, choose the better hamburger, choose Wendy's. Square's the beef. All right, let's get going. Okay, starting off hot, Hulkster and Alexa Bliss flexing. Great set we got here. Great reflective floor. Hulkster getting after it, and there he comes. The world's best snake oil salesman. Obviously everybody on their feet. We're in MetLife Stadium, I believe. New York, well, New Jersey. Home of the Jets, home of the Giants. Home of my first WrestleMania, actually. Debuted WrestleMania 29 here. The Shield and a six-man tag to open the show. So both times that I have been on WrestleMania at MetLife, I have opened the show. Little known trivia fact there for you. This match was originally not scheduled to open the show. It was scheduled to be on semi-main event right before the girls closed the show for the very first time. And the preference was, well, if you're not gonna close WrestleMania, you might as well open it. There he comes, look at him. Look at that specimen. Universal champion, red strap on him, just looking huge, traps, enormous. What a freak he is, man. Beefy dude. Sure, he eats a lot of beef. Probably Wendy's beef. One thing that was a bummer about this, opening the show kind of in a surprise way, this fashion with Paul coming down and almost hijacking WrestleMania, is that there was a really awesome video package that the WWE production team had put together for me that was gonna go on before our match. That never got to see the light of day, at least in a pay-per-view format. It's on YouTube, I believe. This band that I really like called Hit the Lights, they put the soundtrack, we were able to get the song from them. It fit perfectly with the theme of the story of my rise kind of to this match, and I was really excited for the, you know, kind of the world to see it at WrestleMania, but they didn't get the chance. I don't know that I've really watched this, the entirety of this thing back, ever. Yeah. That's cool. That's cool. Another little tidbit of information on this one is I nearly passed out on my entrance here. You're going to see me come out here fired up, but because we came out early and it was such a late change, I hadn't eaten properly. So I was real fired up. So I'm screaming, hooting, hollering, adrenaline through the roof. And you can see me pause right there. Yep, okay, get it together. See, I kind of stumble there. See that little stumble? That was me nearly passing out. Finally got there. Got it. Got it back. Yeah, it's like when you sit up and you get lightheaded. That was me right there. That's how I felt. Maybe if I had some beefy beef, I wouldn't have nearly passed out on my entrance. God, wild to think about that young cat in the black and the gold. And bam, right out of the gate. Big knee. Whoop! Brock slipped on my hair. Tried to fight back. My hair wetness conditioner. Boom! I will tell you, there's nothing fun about being mauled by Brock Lesnar. The man is the strongest. Oh wow, I don't even remember taking an F5 on the floor. Unadulterated, raw, brute strength is, like, I'm sure there's guys who can like bench press more or squat more or whatever. Oh God. So Funny story on that. I'll get back to Brock being strong. When Brock threw me into the ring there, there's no, you know, there's LED boards on all the rings now. And he thought there was an LED board there, so he thought it was going to be hard. So he threw me into the base of the ring. But there's nothing there. So I just went into the metal underneath the ring. Like this, it's just a metal frame. And my elbow was messed up for months after that. So yeah, God, just immediately in pain. And like I said, he's just the strongest dude on the planet. Just farm boy strength, right? Just unreal. I think he grew up in Minnesota or the Dakotas or something like that. But just, if you put him in a strong man, like, he's gonna beat everybody. I don't care how much you can lift. He's just a beast. And I'm getting mauled. Now Chad can't ring the bell until I give him permission. Until I tell him it's okay, I think. Because he kind of mauled me before the match. Here we are. Now I'm finally getting up to the fortitude. Boom, another knee to the gut. And the match is finally officially started. Oh, and then that happens. So strong. I am not a large man, you know, by WWE standards. I think maybe in real life I'm a full-sized man. WWE standards, in the wrestling world, you know, it's a land of giants, right? I'm not a small, like a large man, but I'm also not a small man. You know, I'm full 6'2", 200 plus pounds, and he's just tossing me like nothing. And to be honest with you, he could probably throw me even further if he really wanted to. Paul out there with his best tan. Whoop, sorry, Chaddo. Oh! Well, you know, he didn't really want to fight fair, you know what I mean? He jumped me before the bell, so sometimes you got to fight fire with fire. Is what it is. Can I get him? Whoop, bingo. Oh, still moving. Heyman very upset outside, can't believe it. Boom! Uh-oh. Third time's a charm. Night-night, Big Papa. Jump on it. Hook the leg, the shoulders down. Got him. Not too many people have beaten Brock Lesnar in the main event or in any matches at WrestleMania. I've done it twice. So I might be the only person who's ever done it twice, to be honest with you. This all happened so fast for me, I didn't even really get a chance to fully enjoy the moment. You know, it's one of those things where you think winning the world title at WrestleMania is going to be a certain way. One of the shorter title matches in WrestleMania history. But it just kind of wasn't the moment I expected it to be. And I think maybe a part of that was because it was such a whirlwind out of the gate, thinking you were going to be on hours later to then being, you know, opening of the show. Endured a lot of punishment. If he just let me get in the ring, we fought fair, might have been a different story, but gotta fight fire with fire, like I said. So, and there we are at the top of the ramp with the title overhead. Fireworks going off. Again, not too many people have gotten the opportunity to do that. I've been able to do it twice now. So, I'm a lucky man, man. Lucky man. So there you have it. There is Seth Rollins versus Brock Lesnar from WrestleMania 35. A good experience all the way around. And I won, so can't be mad at that. And don't forget to watch WrestleMania this Saturday and Sunday on Peacock in the US and WWE Network everywhere else. This episode of WWE Playback was presented by Wendy's. Wendy's is focused on what matters. When it comes to hamburgers, the beef is what matters. That's why they've made their hamburgers square, so you know that they're made with not just any beef, but the beef. Square's the beef.